In celebrating the 10th edition of Defense and Security 2021, which employs the concept of the power of partnership, defense and security's success has been built on relations that employ developing partnerships. Defense and Security 2021 will focus on regional cooperation and business partnerships for a more united and effective response regarding disaster management, cybersecurity, anti-terrorism, and defense production. Investment in the government's Eastern Economic Corridor, EEC project, also offers opportunities for business partnerships to expand their business to Thailand and to sectors of the defense industry. The show has a rich history of partnering with multinational corporations, manufacturers, delegations, military decision makers, and related government officials, especially from ASEAN. Defense and Security 2021, Tri-Service Asian Defense and Security Exhibition, Conference and Networking Event. The show has grown bigger and more important every year, fully supported by the Thai Ministry of Defense and the Royal Thai Armed Forces. Defense and Security 2021 is based on four unique concepts. Static display. Technical presentations and international conferences. Live demonstrations. Networking opportunities. The 2021 show is expected to be over 25% larger than the previous edition. Over 550 exhibiting companies from 50 countries. Over 30 national pavilions from Europe, South Africa, Asia, the Middle East, ASEAN, and USA. Over 21,000 professional decision makers from 65 countries. Over 400 delegates and key decision makers from 35 countries, represented by Ministers of Defense, Chiefs of Armed Forces, Army, Navy, and Air Force, especially from ASEAN. There is no better place than Defense and Security 2021. Mark your dates. 1 to 4 November 2021. Impact Exhibition and Convention Center, Bangkok, Thailand.
Good afternoon, everyone. Before starting the webinar, I would like to give you some instruction about Q&A session.
สวัสดีค่ะผู้เข้าฟังทุกๆท่านนะคะก่อนที่จะเริ่มเวบินาร์ในวันนี้ก็ขออธิบายรายละเอียดเล็กน้อยเกี่ยวกับการถามคำถามกับทางวิทยากรค่ะ
All microphone and video of the attendee are mute. If you have any question to ask our speaker while the speaker are speaking, please list them down in the Q&A box below.
ถ้าท่านผู้ฟังท่านใดนะคะต้องการที่จะถามคำถามกับทางวิทยากรในขณะที่วิทยากรกำลังการทำการเสวนาอยู่นั้นนะคะก็กรุณาเขียนคำถามของท่านลงได้ที่ Q&A box ทางแถบด้านล่างได้เลยค่ะหลังจากที่ทางวิทยากรได้ทำการเสวนาเสร็จแล้วนะคะจะมีทีมงานลิสต์คำถามให้กับทางวิทยากรได้ตอบค่ะลำดับต่อไปขอส่งต่อให้กับทางพิธีกรค่ะ Next over to the moderator.
Okay, good afternoon from Thailand. Defense and Security 2022 by GML Exhibition Thailand in collaboration with the ThaiArmedForce.com would like to welcome you to the online seminar, A Glimpse of Thailand's Defense Industry in the 21st Century. My name is Anarayo Gosakun from ThaiArmedForce.com and I will be your moderator today. This event will be delivered in English and we will have a summary in Thai at the end of each question. So if you have your question, Please leave the question at the chat box and we will receive your question at the Q&A session later in the seminar. ก็ขอต้อนรับทุกท่านนะครับเข้าสู่การสัมมนาการส่งเสริมความยั่งยืนด้านเทคโนโลยีอุตสาหกรรมป้องกันประเทศของประเทศไทยนะครับในทศวรรษที่21งานจัดโดย Defense and Security 2022แล้วก็ thaiarmforce.com นะครับสำหรับการเสวนาในวันนี้เราจะดำเนินการเป็นภาษาอังกฤษนะครับแต่ว่าเดี๋ยวผมจะสรุปคำถามแล้วก็คำตอบเป็นภาษาไทยให้กับทุกท่านหลังจากคำถามแต่ละคำถามนะครับแต่ว่าถ้าท่านใดมีคำถามเนี่ยก็สามารถที่จะพิมพ์เอาไว้ในกล่องแชทได้นะครับแล้วก็เดี๋ยวเราจะตอบคำถามหลังจากช่วงการ presentation นะครับฝากได้ทั้งภาษาไทยแล้วก็ภาษาอังกฤษครับอย่างที่เราทราบกันดีก็คือประเทศไทยเราประสบกับภาวะวิกฤตเศรษฐกิจจากโควิด-19 นะครับซึ่ง thaiarmforce.com ประเมินว่างบประมาณกลาโหมเนี่ยจะไม่กลับมาสู่ภาวะเดิมนะครับก่อนยุคโควิดนะครับจนกว่าจะถึงปี2570อย่างไรก็ตามนะครับอุตสาหกรรมป้องกันประเทศแล้วก็อุตสาหกรรมการบินเนี่ยก็เป็น S-curve ที่รัฐบาลต้องการสนับสนุนนะครับซึ่งมีสิทธิพิเศษด้านการส่งเสริมการลงทุนแล้วก็ภาษีหลายอย่างการจัดหาอาวุธจากอุตสาหกรรมป้องกันประเทศของไทยเนี่ยหรือการเปิดโอกาสให้อุตสาหกรรมป้องกันประเทศของไทยเนี่ยร่วมมือกับต่างประเทศเพื่อเสนอผลิตภัณฑ์ให้กับกองทัพไทยก็จะเป็นอีกช่องทางหนึ่งนะครับในการที่ทำให้กองทัพเนี่ยสามารถที่จะจัดหาอาวุธได้โดยที่ได้รับผลประโยชน์ทางเศรษฐกิจตอบแทนด้วยนะครับโดยวันนี้เนี่ยเราก็จะได้รับเกียรติจากผู้เชี่ยวชาญจากสถาบันเทคโนโลยีป้องกันประเทศของกระทรวงกลาโหมมาให้ข้อมูลในเรื่องของความร่วมมือนี้นะครับ The Thai defense industry faced the enormous challenge due to the pandemic that pushed Thailand into the worst economic crisis since the 1997 Asian economic crisis and we see the most of the resources diverted to fund the economic stimulusFrom the fiscal year 2019, we see $1.4 billion decrease in the defense budget, and the ThaiArmedForce.com estimate that the defense budget will not return to the pre-COVID era until around 2027. But this crisis created an opportunity. Defense and aerospace industry is being promoted by the government as an S-curve with the some tax benefit and the investment support.This could provide the clause for the Thai defense procurement if that procurement is being procured from the Thai defense industry. This is also create an opportunity for the global defense firm and supplier to partner with the local defense industry to offer the product with the economic benefit and utilize investment promotion from the Thai government. So today we will be speaking with the official from the Defense Technology Institute of the Thai Ministry of Defense or the DTI, as they are promoting the defense research and collaboration. It's our honor to, for us today to have Ms. Rungnari Pachapap, Director of the Commercial Business Development, and Mr. Thanarak Thanasombun, Defense Analyst from the Defense Technology Institute to talk about the DTI and how the private sector can work with them to create the business opportunity in Thailand. Good afternoon, everyone. So first question goes to Ms. Rungnari. Can youTell us who is the DTI, what is your mission, and what is your concept of working with Thai defense industry?
Yes, sir. Thank you, Mr. Anarayo, and good afternoon, everyone, again. Yeah, I'm Rungnari from Defense Technology Institute. The first, let me ask you to understand about the DTI. We have to use the TI, what it stands for, Defense Technology.Industry and Defense Technology Institute for today, for this section. Next, please. Let me tell you in briefly about the DTI. DTI has been established for 12 years ago, and DTI is a public organization. It should be under the Defense Technology Decree in 2008, and with the objective of researching and developing the weapon and defense technology until we get to the research prototype.But EOC would be not to able to take it to the industry and production level. So, however, we have to escalate to organization in the defense technology innovation and will encourage expansion into the business commercial in the defense technology in Thailand. Therefore, DTI has been approved by Ministry of Defense to reorganize the structure and operating procedure.To promote and carry out different industry activity in symmetrical ways as well. So, it has been changed to exhibit under Defense Technology Act since the 1st of May 2019 from now on. Next please. Yes, you have to see this is a relation between DTI and Ministry of Defense. Yeah, you have to see that DTI will be still under the Ministry of Defense. Right now, DTI has three levels in management policy level. The first one, I mean the first box at the upper, you have to see that DTI Technology Policy Committee, who is comprised of the Ministry of Defense as the chairman. So the committee has an authority to oversee and determine the policy and goal of DTI operation. And also, they are also intermediate the guideline to promotion and support the public sector and private sector in carrying out the activity of DTI technology and industry, as well as also to provide suggestion and recommendation to Ministry of Defense to propose to the Cabinet of Coordination with the respect to matters relating into the promotion and support defense technology and defense industry too. Therefore, I'm going to the next box, I mean at the middle box. DTI has also the board of directors who are responsible for oversee and general administration of the institute that to ensure that it will be compliant with the objective of DTI. And the last one, DTI Technology Institute, I mean the last box is at the bottom. DTI has been organized by DTI Director General who will manage activity to be submit the regulation, role, and objective of DTI. Then you have to see that this is the management level of DTI policy. Yes, please go to next slide. Yeah, come to the DTI objective. You have to see the DTI objective as there. There are five objectives under the X as display on the slide, but then main objective of DTI are starting from research and development and research DTI industry, training, cooperate and knowledge management. However, today we would like to focus on number two issue. Next please. Sorry. Okay, then according to number two issue, is its current today activity. Then DTI has been ready to promote and push it up the different industry shall be suitable in the future. Yeah. From the objective as previous, right? We will select that the TI duty are important with it being concerned the defense technology industry as the first one to engage in activity in the defense industry. The second one to enter into a agreement and cooperate with other organizations or agency in the public sector and private sector, both in Thailand and overseas. And the third one to exhibit ensuring exhibit organization with its juristic person as well as invest in, co-share in, or become a partner. And the last one, to provide services related to the testing or certifying the testing result with respect to equipment, prototype, and products. Yeah, is that all objective, all DTI objective and authorized can support and promote Thai industry will be settled in Thailand.
Okay, thank you, Ms. Lungnari. This is the Thai summarization for the Thai speaker and our Thai colleagues. อันนี้เป็นสรุปภาษาไทยนะครับของคำถามที่ผ่านมานะครับผมถามว่าภารกิจของ DTI คืออะไรนะครับอยากให้ช่วยอธิบายคร่าวๆคำตอบก็คือว่า DTI เนี่ยก็เป็นหน่วยงานวิจัยและพัฒนาของกระทรวงกลาโหมนะครับแล้วก็มี DTI มีการเปลี่ยนแปลงกฎหมายในปี2019นะครับเพื่อให้สามารถผลิตแล้วก็ขายได้นะครับโดยที่ DTI เนี่ยก็จะอยู่ภายใต้กำกับของกระทรวงกลาโหมนะครับซึ่งก็จะมีคณะกรรมการเพื่อกำหนดนโยบายด้านอุตสาหกรรมป้องกันประเทศนะครับซึ่งวัตถุประสงค์ของ DTI เนี่ยก็มีหลายประการนะครับหนึ่งในนั้นก็คือการสนับสนุนแล้วก็ส่งเสริมอุตสาหกรรมการประเทศแล้วก็สามารถที่จะจัดตั้งองค์กรหรือว่านิติบุคคลหรือว่าร่วมลงทุนกับภาคเอกชนหรือภาคส่วนที่เป็นพันธมิตรได้นะครับผมอันนี้คือคำถามแรกนะครับที่ถามคุณลุงนรี So the second question go to Mr. Thanarak. Can you tell us what is the perspective of DTI towards the Thai defense market? Is there any update on the current situation in Thailand and in the region?
Thank you, sir. I would like to inform you about the big picture of the global defense situation that is already including in the Thailand as well. So next slide, please. So mostly about the defense situation in Thailand and all around the world is quite a little bit similar in some way. Mostly about the defense force in Thailand. At this moment, we are focusing about the border control, insurgency surveillance, such as in the southern part of Thailand, or even the COVID-19 prevention about the immigrant and whatever about that my concern about the COVID as well. But this is the part that everyone is in every country is going to do as well. But in another part about in Thailand, in Thailand, we have about the, we are staying in the Southeast Asia, and we have the effect about the system from the something that is happened in the South China Sea dispute. And another one thing is about in the major power in the world, something like the strategic in the Belt and Road or Indo-Pacific from the main China and or United States as well. That is some kind of effect into the defense situation and defense industry as well. So next slide, please. I would like to give you a brief concern about the domain of operation now today that is quite changed quite a lot from the way we used to in the Cold War situation. And about the technology trend and the global defense industry, they have quite changed a lot about this one. It's not only about the simple battle in the battlefield anymore. And some kind of we are get used to about the air, land, sea, or some people concerned about the space and cyberspace. And actually, the situation in the globe, in the defense industry and technology at this moment is include both of them about the wartime and the peacetime. So it means about before we are going to the battle or something else, before that one, we need to win something like the public opinion, the economic situation as well. Because the military hardware is cost a lot. If you cannot win the public opinion, you cannot get the money or budget to procure some equipment about the military system. So it means you need to consider a lot of influencer that is some kind that you can call multi-domain warfare as well to achieve something you want in, or something in your business. I would like to make you sure about, okay, this one maybe is look very complex, but in another way, it means another market as well. And okay, I would like to show you about the next slide, please. So mostly about in the defense situation, mostly they're concerned about the three parts of them. The first part is about the innovation or R&D agency. And another one is about the industrial body. This one caused a lot of economic effect. And the last one is about the defense and security user who procure or who use the military hardware in some kind of operation they want. So it means it's another group of customer. So it means about if you are the stakeholder of the defense industry, you can be classified yourself about which part do you want to go or which part do you want to collaborate as well. This will concern about in Thailand as well. We are not different from the other country. So next slide, please. So I can show you some about the defense trend, defense technology trend that is happening now today. They have a lot of technology trend changing in the past 10 years or 20 years. So I can example about some kind like the new technology emerging, AI licensing, cyber capability or unmanned system that is affect a lot of multiple domain of pattern operation. But I would like you to consider about the last part about this something is some kind of the board of opportunity and about the effect on in industry as well. It's about the adaptability in the defense supply chain. What does this mean about the supply chain about this one? Because defense supply chain is very close to the civilian product more than anyone thinks about. And what are going to be in the very future soon. It's about defense supply chain is something is very sophisticated and very complex. And they have already set up for a very long time ago, 10 years, 20 years, sometime behind after the Cold War. And at this moment, they are going to be changed again. And it's quite a big change. But why they need to change that? I have shown some kind of the effect that I showed you with the slide already. Some kind of the trade war effect or technology war effect or the global defense budget effect as well. For the first one, you can imagine about, okay, at this moment, most of everyone know about they have some conflict between the superpower in the region, right? Some kind of the from China or the from US. This is the part of the strategy that they try to build for their own region as well. And actually in Thailand, we are in the some kind of the influence from the major power in this area. So you can imagine about after we set up the defense economic and defense industry completely 100% already. But at this moment, they are going to shake quite a lot because of they need to move the location somewhere, move the factory, move the agency, move the system from one place to another place. When we are going to discuss about this one, it costs a lot of investment as well to return, but they need to do something because in the some kind of when they have the happen between the major power, it mean about you need to consider about the leaks about the war, leaks about the trading, leaks about the tax efficiency, leaks about the logistics that is appear all around the world. So it means you need to do secondary chain or alternative route to continue. It looks like the BCP or business continuity plan, but in terms of the global defense, it's quite a lot of this one. And it will lead to another question is one about what is the barrier to exit from one place? And what is the barrier to entry to another country? This one is going to cost a lot and it's quite very long term or permanently change. It's not something that will happen in 1 or 2 years, but you can consider about the time span or window around 5 or 10 years before moving the location, one location to another location. So in this case, I would like to introduce all of you to think about this one is considered about the opportunity as well to consider to do about something into this very big supply chain in the future. So next slide, please. And what is going to be in the Thailand after they have maybe relocation or supply chain change or something? And what is the situation in the Thailand budget and Thailand market as well? Mostly you can consider about, okay, they have two parts in the Thailand group. One part is the very big part is the MOD group, right? Ministry of Defense for the Armed Force. And another one is non-MOD group, something like that, some kind of DTI. We can some kind of both of the customer or the supplier as well in some way. But they have two separate system about this one. So you can consider, you can have both of these two customer. So next slide, please. And we can summarize about the last year budget about in the very, very next year, next fiscal year. MOD budget is still continue cutting another 5.24% from the last year. That is understandable because about the effect of the COVID-19 pandemic. This is caused a lot in the defense procurement. So it's mean about what is going to affect. It's mean about when we have really low on the budget. So it's in the procurement, the whole new system is mostly leaked or most is quite very really difficult. I did not say about it will be completely cut off, but it will be very difficult to obtain that budget in the next few years. So next slide, please. And we are going to forecast about what's going to happen. This one is allowed in the next 5 years ago. You can see about the forecast. The budget in the MOD defense is will be serving quite a little bit, but it will take around 4 or 5 years before they can reach it back before the COVID era. So it's mean about in this moment, when the government or the MOD deciding to do something about the procurement, they need to consider a lot because we have very low on budget as well, but we still have a lot of equipment and military hardware from the Cold War era that needs to be replaced or modernization in the very near future. So this one is opening another market as well and open another opportunity for the local and domestic that makes us cost cheaper and more efficiency in the long run supply chain as well. Next slide, please. I think next slide might be show you about the system in the Thailand procurement at this moment. It's not different from the last year, but I can show about, okay, from the perspective of 100%, you can see about is the procurement part is only 7.54%. That is quite a very small margin compared to the another part. So it means about it will be tight situation for a short week or a short year coming. So next slide, please. this one I would like to give you a brief picture aboutwhat happened if you are going to do about the defense Thailand industry or defense Thailand market. If I'm not about the defense industry user or defense procurement system, how can I interact with this one? I would like to show about this model, about this one. It's not doesn't mean about the every military hardware need to be controlled or compromised or fit in only in the black box system. Mostly you can see about from the military side and civilian side,They can share a lot of the system. I can example about the automobile industry in Thailand. That is quite a really big system in Thailand already. They can talk about a lot of things about the tire, the system, the huge, the chassis. That is, all, most of them is the civilian products. And in the middle part is about you can, from this one, you can upgrade from the civilian, completely civilian to some kind of the defense product as well. Some kind about the 4x4 vehicle, 8x8 vehicle,A lot of systems still use the civilian product or civilian service as well. They have only some kind of the sophisticated system that you need to meet to a lot of control by regulation, such as the explosive device, the fire control system, or the very sophisticated software that used in the battle management system. But that is only the small part. I can say about more than 80% of the system in Thailand can consider civilian can be joined in somewhere in this one.I think, okay, I will summarize about this part of the big picture of the global defense and Thailand around this one. Okay, I think this one, I will return to the mod first. And Mr. Lung Nali, I think Ms. Lung Nali can show you about the, what kind of the DTI going to do in the, this system in the Thailand defense industry.
Yeah, thank you, sir. Yeah, perhaps you already get to know about the overall and different technology and different trend from the Khun Thanarat already. Yes, please come back to look at DTI. DTI had initiative to focus on research and development. That we have been responsibility to study research and development different technology innovations and including support and promote activity in the different industry. And then to become self-reliance and slightly reduce the import for foreign industry. So DTI has set the target technology platform in the 5 technology S. Next slide, please. Yeah, there's a 5 technology platform in the DTI. The first one, we set the unmanned vehicle system technology. The second one, combat vehicle and weapon system technology. The third one, simulation and virtual reality technology. And the fourth, military information and communication technology. And the last one, rocket and guided missile technology. This is all technology to be support like a new use like Khun Thanarat used to talk before, that I mean it can be used for the military target and civilian target also. So therefore the research and development activity of DTIs, we do not start from the beginning, but DTI have to create a network to coordinate and cooperate in the field of different technology with the other like government unit, academic institute or private section, both of domestic material and internationally. Therefore, which is the option is, I mean, the networking can help us obtain a research prototype faster to respond the need of user requirements, and it will be useful to help the user can set the procurement processing concretely. Therefore, and another thing is it important for the management role under the X is the integration of the cooperation with government agency and private sector for developing different technology innovations to promote and push it on business commercialization. Yeah, for next slide, please. This is a sample of research and development of DTI in the 5 target technology that we handle right now. Next, please. Yeah, next slide, please.You can come back to the previous slide, please. Yeah, Mr. Anaro, you have your hand question about the Mr. Tanat mentioned, please.
Yes, maybe I interrupt here, and so I can summarize your long answers to our Thai colleagues. เดี๋ยวอันนี้เป็นการสรุปคำถามที่สองนะครับแล้วก็คำตอบพอดียาวนิดนึงนะครับผมก็เดี๋ยวขอสรุปเป็นภาษาไทยนะครับผมก็คือคำถามที่สองเนี่ยผมถามทั้งสองท่านว่าในมุมมองของ DTI เนี่ยDTI มองตลาดหรือว่ามองอุตสาหกรรมป้องกันประเทศของไทยอย่างไรนะครับผมก็วิทยากรสองท่านก็ตอบมานะครับในภาพรวมก็คือว่ากองทัพไทยเนี่ยก็ยังมุ่งภารกิจไปที่การดูแลชายแดนนะครับแล้วก็การรับมือกับโควิด19นะครับในเอเชียตะวันออกเฉียงใต้ก็ยังมีความขัดแย้งอยู่นะครับยังเป็นภูมิภาคที่ยังมีความขัดแย้งส่วนเทรนด์การพัฒนาเทคโนโลยีในปัจจุบันนะครับก็จะมีพวก AI นะครับด้านไซเบอร์แล้วก็ด้านอันแมนต่างๆนะครับซึ่งก็จะเปลี่ยนโฉมหน้าในการปฏิบัติภารกิจนะครับรวมถึงมีสิ่งที่ต้องสนใจก็คือว่าการปรับตัวของห่วงโซ่อุปทานนะครับที่อยู่ในอุตสาหกรรมป้องกันประเทศซึ่งอาจจะได้รับผลกระทบจากภาวะการเมืองของภาวะการเมืองระหว่างประเทศต่างๆนะครับเช่นพวกเทรดวอลหรือว่ากฎระเบียบต่างๆที่ทำให้การแสวงหาห่วงโซ่อุปทานของอุตสาหกรรมป้องกันประเทศใหม่ๆเนี่ยก็เป็นสิ่งที่ควรจะต้องพิจารณาเพื่อลดความเสี่ยงนะครับผมสำหรับประเทศไทยเองเนี่ยการพัฒนาขีดความสามารถด้านการป้องกันประเทศในปัจจุบันเนี่ยก็ยังจะมุ่งไปที่การซ่อมบำรุงนะครับการฝึกการอัปเกรดแล้วก็การสร้างโครงสร้างพื้นฐานด้านอุตสาหกรรมป้องกันประเทศแล้วก็การจัดหาอาวุธใหม่นะครับแต่ว่างบประมาณของกระทรวงกลาโหมเนี่ยก็ลดไป 5.24% เลยในปี2022นะครับซึ่งก็คือปี2565นั่นเองซึ่งก็ทำให้หลายโครงการจัดหาเนี่ยต้องมีการเลื่อนออกไปนะครับแต่ว่าการก็เป็นการสร้างโอกาสใหม่นะครับให้กองทัพเนี่ยสามารถที่จะให้ความสนใจกับอุตสาหกรรมป้องกันประเทศของไทยได้นะครับรวมถึงก็มีความท้าทายในการทำความเข้าใจกับสาธารณชนนะครับเพื่อลดแรงต่อต้านในการจัดหายุทโธปกรณ์ในภาวะวิกฤตนี้นะครับโดยสำหรับ DTI แล้วเนี่ยก็จะมีภารกิจในการวิจัยแล้วก็พัฒนาอาวุธนะครับซึ่งในปัจจุบันเนี่ยก็จะมุ่งไปที่5เทคโนโลยีนะครับก็คือว่าเทคโนโลยีอันแมนเทคโนโลยียานรบนะครับเทคโนโลยีซิมูเลชันนะครับแล้วก็เทคโนโลยี ICT รวมถึงเทคโนโลยีจรวดต่างๆนะครับแต่ว่าDTI เนี่ยก็จะไม่ได้ทำตั้งแต่ศูนย์นะครับแต่ว่าจะใช้วิธีร่วมมือกับภาคการศึกษาแล้วก็ภาคเอกชนแล้วก็มุ่งไปที่การผลิตในเชิงพาณิชย์ในที่สุดนะครับแล้วก็ต่อไปจะเป็นคำถามที่3นะครับ So sorry I interrupt you Ms. Lungali this is the third question for you so why should the private sector work with the DTI and how will the DTI promote and cooperate with the private firm any mechanism to show usMaybe you need to.
Sorry, I'm okay. I'm sorry. Yeah, according to the mission and objective, our DTI, VTI, we were seeking for any action to take and try to coordinate and cooperate and create the networking. And presently, the development of cooperation network we have to divide into two main activities.The first one, we focus on research and development. And the second one, we focus on different industry support. Yeah, however, from now on, there are many organizations have been our networking. Like the next slide, you have to see. Next slide, please. Next slide, please. Yeah, you have to see that. Come back, please. Please, okay.This is a sample of the DTI networking that you have right now. So you have to see the logo and trademark of them. Okay, this sample. Yeah, please come back to coordinate activities. Next slide, please. Yes, cooperate in the research and development. Yeah, go to next slide, please. The cooperation of the network developing in the research and development, both of the partner that mean DTI and other would be agreed to join doing something together. However, the implementation through the Memorandum of Understanding or MOU and Memorandum of Agreement or MOA in order to support and exchange resources together, such as regulation, budget, equipment, human resources,knowledge and others. And the most importantly, the cooperation at least from the research and development is the first necessity to the joint investment joint operation, joint venture with DTI in the case of joint exhibits of juristic person to produce and sell as well. So this is in terms of research and domain cooperation. Next, please. Yeah, we are going to the cooperation in different industry support. Yes, according to the objective and following the different technology acts in the section number 23 and section number 24, therefore it has come up with a business model to promote the different industry. Then you look at next piece. Then you look at the next slide, this slide. Joint exhibition a legal entity, we have to separate into two categories. As product and sale purpose and service and the other purpose that can be joint investment, joint operation and joint venture. And initially, DIS tried to adapt the process like co-investment that we have to be a business joining either joint venture or consortium and also shareholding and partnership too. Therefore, the activities depend on our discussion is either what would we like to do together. And in addition to the different technology acts enable to explore various methods such as sales representative or the private sector in the industry promotion as per the investment and sales representative regulators. Yes, DTI has important to be support and promote the different industry to become self-reliant and reduce military goods imports. Yeah, next slide, please. Yeah, at the beginning to promote different industry, DTI has considered pilot project in the different business according to DTI policy and grow by the following these criteria. The first one, the product and promote of DTI industry, DTI has considered pilot projects in different divisions according to DTI policy and grow. The first one, the product that is research and development by DTI with military standards certified and also ready to manufacture. The second one, we have to grant investment from domestic and foreign private section. And the last one for the criteria that we meet, the show you that the project proposal by Thai private sector and being supported by DTI as per the S-Club 11 policy according to the different technology as well. Next piece. Yeah, this slide will show you the various of project that DTI is working on or the project are still in the business negotiation. By the way, we can divide into the two categories. The first one, we look at the manufacturing and sale, such as joint investment, joint operation, and joint venture. In the case of exhibit to juristic person. And the second one, service joint venture in the case of consortium. However, every ongoing project is an appropriate arising from the cooperation of the research and development of DTI. Yes, please. Yes, sir.
Okay, yeah. Maybe I need to interrupt this a bit because I should summarize the question to our Thai colleagues now. คำถามที่3นะครับผมก็เลยถามคุณลุงนรีว่าทำไมแล้วก็ทำอย่างไรที่ภาคเอกชนนะครับรวมถึงภาคอุตสาหกรรมเนี่ยจะร่วมมือกับ DTI แล้วก็ DTI เนี่ยจะช่วยเหลือภาคเอกชนแล้วก็ภาคอุตสาหกรรมอย่างไรนะครับซึ่งตรงนี้เนี่ยก็ได้รับคำตอบว่า DTI ก็จะมองหาความร่วมมือเพื่อสร้างเครือข่ายนะครับซึ่งก็มีกิจกรรมทั้งการวิจัยแล้วก็การพัฒนานะครับแล้วก็การสนับสนุนอุตสาหกรรมป้องกันประเทศซึ่งในตอนนี้เนี่ยก็มีหลายหน่วยงานที่ทำความร่วมมือกับ DTI แล้วนะครับในการวิจัยแล้วก็พัฒนาเนี่ยก็จะทำผ่านการทำ MOU นะครับแล้วก็ MOA ซึ่งก็จะเป็นการทำข้อตกลงในการแบ่งทรัพยากรต่างๆนะครับก็เป็นการดำเนินการก่อนที่จะมีการจัดตั้งนิติบุคคลร่วมกันนะครับเพื่อร่วมลงทุนในการผลิตแล้วก็ขาย ซึ่งตรงนี้ก็จะมีหลักเกณฑ์ในการพิจารณาการร่วมลงทุนนะครับก็คือเพื่อดำเนินธุรกิจแล้วก็กิจกรรมการตลาดของผลิตภัณฑ์ที่ DTI วิจัยแล้วก็พัฒนาแล้วแล้วก็ผ่านการรับรองมาตรฐานแล้วนะครับหรือว่าอาจจะมีการร่วมทุนแล้วก็ดำเนินกิจกรรมในผลิตภัณฑ์ที่เอกชนเนี่ยมีการผลิตอยู่แล้วหรือว่าเป็นการขอรับการสนับสนุนอื่นๆนะครับซึ่งก็เป็นไปตามนโยบาย S-curve ที่11ของรัฐบาลนะครับโดยก็มีตัวอย่างที่คุณลุงนรียกตัวอย่างมานะครับก็คือว่าเช่นการผลิตแล้วก็ขายนะครับในคือหมายถึงว่าก็จะมี2แบบนะครับที่ DTI ทำตอนนี้ก็คือ1ก็คือการผลิตแล้วขายก็คือโครงการก็เป็นโครงการยานเกราะ 4x4 นะครับโครงการอาวุธปืนโครงการอากาศยานไร้คนขับนะครับแล้วก็โครงการเรือ UAV เรือ OPV นะครับคือเรือตรวจการไกลฝั่งรวมถึงโครงการยานเกราะ 8x8รวมถึงในอีกด้านหนึ่งนะครับคือการให้บริการด้านอุตสาหกรรมป้องกันประเทศนะครับคือการซ่อมบำรุงปรับปรุงอาวุธปืนนะครับการซ่อมบำรุงหุ่นยนต์เก็บกู้วัตถุระเบิดแล้วก็การฝึกอบรมนักบิน UAV นั่นเองครับอันนี้ก็เป็นคำถามที่3นะครับผม so the next question to two of you any case study on this so do you have any project or success story to show us how the defense collaboration work with the DTI
Let me come to let you know. Thank you, Ms. Anaryo. I will list you into the two sample which the project are going on with us. At the first sample of in the case of manufacturing and sale as the Thai Defense Industry Company Limited. Yeah, the Thai Defense Industry Company Limited has modeled to exhibit a new company.By joint investment between DTI and Chaiseri Metal and Rubber Company Limited. The reason that Chaiseri would like to sell the 4x4 first wing to foreign country, but the procurement regulation of that country would like to conduct the business by government or G2G. Thus, Chaiseri has been come to us to consult for the suggestion.Therefore, the authority of the Thai Defense Act exactly Chaiseri think that DTI can help and support them. So, however, DTI and Chaiseri already had a MOU in research and development together. As I used to tell you in the previous slide that about the, with the corporate to MOU will be, should be to get the juristic person. So, in order to according the compliance with the TI authority, we had to discuss and negotiate to do a business together as a business analysis, such as customer analysis, market analysis, risk management, or others, until we get a business plan. After we get the business plan, we have to propose the business plan proposal to the DTI committee who have to authorize to consideration, and then.Currently, DTI and Chaiseri has agreed to exhibit a new company under the name of Thai Defense Industry Company Limited to produce and sell 4x4 wheel armor vehicle. We have to focus on domestic and international market also. Yeah.It is a sample, the first sample in the case of manufacturing and sale. May I go to the second sample and the second one? Next slide, please. Yeah, we have to select the service category in the case of unmanned system maintenance. Yes, this project is a service project for the maintenance of unmanned ground vehicles and unmanned underwater vehicles as a result ofDTI has carried out research and development in explosive disposal robot project, or we call the EOD robot project. And I say just in the slide before about the research and development of DTI will be not start from the beginning, but we have to cooperate with others like a government sector, educational institute, and private sector. However, the implementation in the past of the EOD project.I found that many users have problems and failure in the maintenance or repair their existing robots, which error in the case of age depreciation or obsolete program, battery depreciation, and there are insufficiency spare parts like short supply of spare parts because of the introduction line in foreign countries has stopped production. Then and the person DTI has always surveyed the number of robots in the Thailand that the military want to be maintained and repaired. You have to know that normally most of robots in military are purchased from abroad. So our supply chain has been coming from overseas also. Therefore, if you have some problems or crisis from the partner, such as the COVID-19 situation today in the world, it make the management system, operation system, or touring system are limited from the overseas. For this reason, we have to know that DTI has a knowledge management from the research and development in this project, including I know that customer requirement and economical budget saving, as well as we can promote to support and expansion the different industry in Thailand. DTI has announced an invitation to private organization with the capability and potential to submit proposal to invest with DTI in the consortium model. Clearly, DTI has selected and got a private company already. That the company that we select is a technology research and development company limited to be our partner right now. Now we had to negotiate and formulate a business plan together. And now on, we are in the process of making a contract. Yes, before the sample of the second example. Do you have any questions? Do you have more information about Mr. Thanalat?
Yes, please. I would like to give you some more information about these two case studies of us as well. Actually, we have many more case studies, but these two, we are just put it into the example. These two things about the case Chai Seli, about the 4x4 and the EOD system, they have two things that VDTI is one of the public sector, the public organization, and another party is the private sector. It's a completely private sector. But we try to collaborate each other to solve our the same problem, because some kind of the other two, the both of party, they have some limitation. In case of Chai Seli about the 4x4 vehicle, Chai Seli company, they are already have the facility, a really huge one, facility to build the 4x4 for the foreign customer. But actually when they try to going into the foreign market, they are always have some requirement from the customer in many places. Something such as in this case about the Chai Seli, our customer want to do a really big bidding. So it's mean about they need some kind of guarantee from the government. So they prefer to do in term of the G2G procurement. So it's mean G2G procurement is not some kind that easily to do, in especially about the defense product, because we are going to say about the weapon system, the armor system is quite very sophisticated as well. So it means in this case, even though Chai Seli have a lot of capability already, but because they are already private sector, they cannot do the G2G by themselves. So it means this one kind of the connection that DTI and Chai Seli, we are already have the R&D program as well, but this one we can serve each other to do some kind of the business in the foreign country as well. This is a good thing, because we are open a new marketing. It does not limit about the Chinese need to sell something in the Thailand only. No, because we can subsidize about the customer requirement in terms of the public organization. Another case study about the unmanned system as well. Actually, in terms of R&D or the product system of the DTI, we already have our robot system. Then we have the company to build, to research, to build a completely new product about this one. But in terms of the customer requirement nowadays, it does not mean about customer always require a new product. Because actually, I can recommend another one example about in the southern part of Thailand. We have the EOD robot team, very skillful, very, very skillful. They are training so hard and very skillful on the EOD system. But when we are going to see the customer and ask them about what kind of robot that they want, they just always say about, I want the same robot because I don't need to practice or retraining or simulate the system or do a retraining skill of our officer. That need cost a lot of effort. Even though they have a money, they still prefer to do with the same system. But the problem is about the same system that they are using, they already used around 10 years ago. That's mean about the supply chain, the shortage of spare parts, or even though the seller, the agent, the agency, some kind, they are already closed. So it's mean about the combat leading situation is to be getting worse. So they just try to find someone, some people who can rebuild this one or refurbish this one to make the come back to the combat leading status again. So it means this one we can consider about, okay, we can go in together with the academic sector or the private sector to serve our customer and with a very cheaper cost than import a new system from abroad as well. So I can see about that we still have many more case studies, but this one is just the two of us. Okay. Can I have a next slide, please? I think we have some question from the chat box as well. I think some question might be answered by this slide. It's about the how to cooperate or how to start the supply to be the supplier agency or how to start the collaboration in Thailand with in case of we have no idea. If we have no idea about how can I start it, well, okay. I think this one might be a brief situation about, okay, to make your decision about the Thailand defense market more easier. Both this one, we can consider both product and service. You can see about, okay, they have four box around this one. The first one is about the commonly government procurement, MOD or non-MOD is up to you. This, the left part is about, it's just a buyer and seller. Okay, you're just going to do the bidding or to the offer your product and service to the customer in MOD or whatever. This one is just a common way. And the second part is about you can go to the defense industry department. They are under the MOD as well. This one is about in case of, okay, you want to establish a new defense manufacturing system in Thailand. You can do with this government agency as well. But this one is what kind of they do. I think I can recommend about, okay, this one is suitable for the people from the foreign country or in Thailand country who have some footprint in Thailand already or some kind of domestic or local industry in some way in Thailand already. Because if you are really new in everything, you need to establish some kind of the local, maybe SME or CC or small enterprise first before you escalate to the full department investor. Okay. And the third choice is about, okay, DTI, our product as well. But DTI, I would like to explain for all of you as well about we are not fully agency. We have the ability or capability to sell or to produce and sell, and we have authorized, but we are not fully agency. We are not the PSA. Mostly we need to do is about, you need to do some kind of collaboration or R&D first. So it means, and after that, you can stop at that point and go to another chart, or you can keep continuing with DTI to establish a new person or a new entity to do a broad manufacturing and sale as well. So you can see about, okay, mostly in terms of DTI, you need to do maybe two steps before selling something. Maybe R&D or collaboration, it does not mean about you need to make a huge R&D system or make a new innovation. It can be a small or big, it's up to you. So it means it can negotiable. And the last part is about maybe etc. Another way, maybe you can go to the EEC because they are subsidized by the S-curve 11 as well, or the G2G procurement or whatever this one. I think these four parts will be classified about, okay, to make a brief introduction and brief understanding about which part do you want to go before you start the defense market in Thailand.
Uh-huh. Well, I think okay. This is the case. We will summarize your answer in Thai for our Thai colleagues. And นั่นเป็นคำถามที่4นะครับเดี๋ยวผมจะขอสรุปเป็นภาษาไทยนะครับก็คือว่าผมก็ถามว่า ทาง DTI เนี่ยมีโปรเจกต์หรือว่ามี case study ที่เป็น success story ที่ผ่านมาเนี่ยเพื่อแสดงให้เห็นถึงตัวอย่างของการร่วมมือกับ DTI กับภาคเอกชนหรือไม่นะครับซึ่งก็วิทยากรก็ตอบว่าก็จะมีตัวอย่าง2ตัวอย่างนะครับก็คือว่าตัวอย่างแรกก็คือการร่วมลงทุนระหว่าง DTI แล้วก็บริษัทชัยเสรีจำกัดนะครับเพื่อสนับสนุนกิจกรรมการขายยานเกราะของบริษัทชัยเสรีซึ่งก็ DTI เนี่ยก็จะสนับสนุนด้านการจัดการกับข้อตกลงระหว่างรัฐบาลต่อรัฐบาลในการขายยานเกราะให้กับต่างประเทศนะครับตามความต้องการของประเทศลูกค้าที่ต้องการดำเนินการจัดหาผ่านหน่วยงานภาครัฐนะครับซึ่งทั้ง2หน่วยงานเนี่ยก็จะมีกิจกรรมการวิจัยและพัฒนาร่วมกันด้วยรวมถึงมีการศึกษาการตลาดนะครับผมซึ่งในปัจจุบันเนี่ย2หน่วยงานเนี่ยจัดตั้งบริษัทที่ชื่อว่าไทยดีเฟนซ์อินดัสทรีนะครับเพื่อดำเนินการผลิตก็ขายยานเกราะส่วนอีกตัวอย่างนึงเนี่ยก็คือการซ่อมบำรุงอากาศยานไร้คนขับนะครับก็หลังจากที่ DTI เนี่ยทำวิจัยแล้วก็พัฒนาหุ่นยนต์เก็บกู้วัตถุระเบิดเนี่ยแล้วก็ทีไหนก็พบว่าหน่วยผู้ใช้เนี่ยมักจะพบปัญหาด้านการซ่อมบำรุงหุ่นยนต์เก็บกู้วัตถุระเบิดนะครับทีไทยเนี่ยก็จึงร่วมมือกับบริษัทที่ชื่อว่า Technology Research and Development นะครับซึ่งเป็นบริษัทของมหาวิทยาลัยเทคโนโลยีมหานครนะครับเพื่อทำการซ่อมบำรุงแล้วก็จัดการกับการส่งกำลังบำรุงของยานไร้คนขับต่างๆนะครับยานใต้น้ำหรือว่าหุ่นยนต์เก็บกู้วัตถุระเบิดซึ่งก็เป็นการดูแลทั้งหุ่นยนต์ที่วิจัยโดย DTI แล้วก็หุ่นยนต์ที่หน่วยผู้ใช้เนี่ยทำการจัดหามาเองนะครับซึ่งก็รวมถึงการซ่อมบำรุงแล้วก็การปรับปรุงหุ่นยนต์เก็บกู้วัตถุระเบิดที่มีใช้งานอยู่แล้วด้วยอันนี้เนี่ยก็เป็นไปตามรีเควสต์หรือก็ตามความต้องการของลูกค้าซึ่งก็คือหน่วยงานเก็บกู้วัตถุระเบิดในประเทศไทยนะครับสำหรับบริษัทที่ต้องการเข้าสู่ตลาดอุตสาหกรรมผู้ก่อประเทศเนี่ยก็จะมี4ทางเลือกนะครับที่สามารถที่จะดำเนินการได้ทางแรกก็คือเข้ามาประมูลงานกับหน่วยผู้ใช้โดยตรงได้เลยนะครับซึ่งอันนี้ก็เป็นไปตามกฎหมายแล้วก็เป็นไปตาม bidding process ในปกติทางที่2คือการร่วมมือกับศูนย์การอุตสาหกรรมป้องกันประเทศแล้วก็พลังงานทหารนะครับเพื่อขอจัดตั้งโรงงานซึ่งอันนี้เนี่ยก็จะเหมาะสมกับผู้เล่นที่มีการดำเนินการแล้วก็มีขีดความสามารถในประเทศไทยอยู่ระดับหนึ่งแล้วนะครับทางที่3เนี่ยก็คือผ่าน DTI ซึ่งก็จะมีทั้งการร่วมวิจัยแล้วก็พัฒนารวมถึงการร่วมมือทางธุรกิจนะครับส่วนที่4เนี่ยก็คือการดำเนินการในช่องทางอื่นๆนะครับทั้งการจัดหาระหว่างรัฐบาลต่อรัฐบาลการลงทุนทำการผลิตในประเทศไทยในพื้นที่ EEC นะครับซึ่งตรงนี้เนี่ยก็อาจจะเกี่ยวข้องกับ DTI ในระดับหนึ่งระดับใดนะครับก็ขึ้นอยู่กับเคส by เคสนะครับคือขึ้นอยู่กับความเหมาะสมนะครับผม so thank you for both of you Ms. Runari and Mr. Thanarak to offer us the big picture and the collaboration process with the DTI I believe the time is approaching the end of the seminar soI need to move to the Q&A session now, and we have some question from our attendees. So I will ask the question to the both of you in Thai and English. And the first question goes to this question: Will DTI introduce the defense offset policy, or is DTI considering defense offset policy? คำถามนี้ก็คือถามว่า DTI เนี่ยจะมีการใช้นโยบาย offset หรือเปล่านะครับหรือว่า DTI เนี่ยกำลังพิจารณาเรื่อง defense offset policy หรือเปล่านะครับผมก็ this question to the speaker please
yes from about the offset policy the first question offset policy we are discussed quite a lot inside the DTI and the MOD as well about how we can implement the offset policy but all I can say at this moment is not yet because actually offset policy is something that is not only in the umbrella of Ministry of Defense. It means about it need to come up with the government decision because offset policy need to consider from a very broad view from the government perspective. So I can say it at this moment is about we have discussed about the offset policy is quite a lot, but not yet at this moment, sir.
โอเค the answer คำถามนะครับคำตอบของคำถามนี้นะครับก็คือว่าจริงๆแล้วก็มีการคุยกันนะครับเรื่อง offset policy แต่ว่ายังไม่ได้มีการทำนะครับเพราะว่า offset policy เนี่ยค่อนข้างกว้างแล้วก็ต้องขึ้นอยู่กับภาพของรัฐบาลด้วยนะครับซึ่งเป็นเรื่องที่ใหญ่กว่าตัวของ DTI เองนะครับผม so next question Although the DTI is a separate organization, could you please discuss its relationship and partnership with the armed forces and service branches, Royal Thai Army, Navy, and Air Force? คำถามนี้คือถามว่า DTI เนี่ยก็เป็นองค์กรที่แยกออกมานะครับจากหน่วยงานอื่นเนี่ยก็อยากจะให้วิทยากรเนี่ยอธิบายว่าDTI กับหน่วยงานอื่นโดยเฉพาะเหล่าทัพเนี่ยทั้งกองทัพบกกองทัพเรือกองทัพอากาศเนี่ยมีความสัมพันธ์หรือว่ามีความร่วมมือกันอย่างไรนะครับ So this question please.
So Do we need an answer in English or Thai or both or something?
Or maybe in English and I will translate in Thai.
Oh, okay, that's right. Okay, in the collaboration with the Thai Armed Force, right? Actually, DTI is the R&D organization that is separate. Actually, it's separate 10 years ago, around 10 years from the Thai Armed Force and separate into the R&D organization unit. So it's mean about most of the facility and the research system in the Thai Armed Force, they hold quite a lot in the DTI system as well. So it's mean about at this moment, we have the collaboration with the Thai Armed Force about the requirement. Because when we the Thai Armed Force want to have the modernization plan about the procurement, about the system, about the whatever they are going to do in the near future. So it means we will collaborate each other about is it possible for DTI to do something like that or not, such as about the missile system, UAV system. So it means about when we try to do something about this one, we need to do something like a feasibility study about is it possible to do something like that. And after that, if it's possible, we will create some kind of connection. It might be in terms of the MOU or MOA between DTI and Thai Armed Force about, okay, what are products you are going to be, and we will try to deliver this product or service to that one as well.
ครับก็สำหรับคำถามนี้นะครับก็คำตอบก็คือว่า DTI เนี่ยก็เป็นหน่วยงานซึ่งเป็นหน่วยงานวิจัยแล้วก็พัฒนานะครับซึ่งก็จะแยกออกมาจากเหล่าทัพกิจกรรมต่างๆในด้านการวิจัยและพัฒนาเนี่ยก็จะมาร่วมกับ DTI ค่อนข้างมากนะครับก็คือว่ามีกิจกรรมการวิจัยและพัฒนาจากเหล่าทัพเนี่ยเข้ามาร่วมกับ DTI ซึ่งก็รวมถึงการรับความต้องการจากเหล่าทัพมาเป็นโจทย์วิจัยของ DTI ด้วยนะครับการเมื่อสิ่งนี้เกิดขึ้นเนี่ยก็จะมีการทำข้อตกลงร่วมกันเพื่อให้เกิดโครงการวิจัยแล้วก็นำไปสู่การส่งมอบผลิตภัณฑ์ให้กับเหล่าทัพได้นะครับอันนี้ก็เป็นคำตอบของคำถามที่2นะครับ next question are there any plan to add further target technology platform คำถามที่3นะครับก็คือเป็นคำถามที่ถามว่าตอนนี้เนี่ย DTI ก็มี target technology อยู่แล้วนะครับก็คือว่ามีแผนที่จะเพิ่ม target technology มากขึ้นไหมครับผม so this question please
As a business normally talk about, okay, DTI have 5 focus technology inside our, it's like the in-house R&D research. But if you ask about, is it possible to increase more technology or something like that, I can say that it will be. Because actually they have, in the defense technology, they have a lot of model and a lot of system that the Thai Armed Force need in the market as well. But actually before we add a newitem or new category of technology. So we need to discuss quite a lot about what we are going to do with the partner. Because in some case, if we want to invest or implement a new technology that we have no facility to support or no ability to support, it will be waste of time and money quite a lot. So it's mean about in case of we have the emerging technology that is quite interesting, DTI might study about this one.And need to ask about, okay, do we have a partnership in Thailand or somewhere else or not? So it means about we can share the system and share the knowledge, including about the shared investment as well, to start a new system. You can have about, okay, from our slide, we have a lot of type of collaboration. Sometimes some project of us, we start from a very small size of R&D, maybe just a paper,The just a very small paper about system R&D about the robotic. And after that, after a few years later, we see opportunity to run the market. So we can increase this one to about another new system and another new market cap as well.
So ง่ายคือเป็นไปได้นะครับก็ขึ้นอยู่กับทาง DTI แล้วก็ขึ้นอยู่กับ requirement ต่างๆนะครับแล้วก็ partner ที่เข้ามาเนี่ยเพื่อคือการร่วมมือกันเนี่ยก็สามารถที่จะร่วมมือจากโครงการเล็กไปใหญ่ซึ่งถ้ามีโอกาสในอนาคตเนี่ยก็สามารถที่จะเพิ่ม target technology ได้นั่นเองนะครับผม next question คำถามต่อไปนะครับก็คือว่าอยากทราบขั้นตอนของบริษัทต่างประเทศหรือว่าบริษัทที่ทำธุรกิจข้ามประเทศนะครับคือว่าถ้าเขาจะเข้ามาในประเทศไทยแล้วก็เข้ามาทำธุรกิจในไทยเนี่ยต้องมีกระบวนการยังไงมีขั้นตอนอย่างไรหรือว่าต้องลงทะเบียนอย่างไรนะครับก็คือ next question isWhat is the procedure for the foreign and the global supplier to register for the Thailand defense to enter the Thai defense market?
Okay, this question is quite a little bit they can answer in two ways. So it depends on the your purpose about this one. I can example about if you have the plan to start the defense market in Thailand, but for the purpose about export to other country, you can go in many places such as the EEC or BOI or supporting technology. And you need, but this question you need to classify themselves first. I think it's a good idea to start the business in Thailand, but you need to classify different two questions first about is it a military or civilian. So because some kind of part of the military system is not need to be always military. You can be in a civilian product as well. So if you mean about if you decide to join about the military side, they have quite a lot of regulation control in both in Thailand, in many countries, because we are talking about the weapon. But if you are thinking about, okay, this is just some part of the civilian product, you can consider, okay, you can have a cheaper product or cheap or shorter procedure to do the business in Thailand. So I think this question is depend on what product you are going to do and what markets you are going to go. So if you are looking at this one, in case of you are going to do the defense hardware or defense military system, I need to you to set up, okay, maybe you can come to DTI to talk about, okay, what you are going to do, what product and service you are going to offer. And you can have some collaboration that maybe do not need to spend a lot of money. And study about the market. Is it opportunity or is it valuable for your business or not? So you can make up summarize before decision that one.
Okay, ครับก็คำตอบนี้นะครับคือว่าก็มีหลายก็มีอยู่หลายๆทางนะครับก็คือว่าเช่นถ้าอยากมาลงทุนเพื่อผลิตแล้วก็ส่งออกเนี่ยจริงๆแล้วเนี่ยก็สามารถที่จะไปขอรับการส่งเสริมการลงทุนจาก BOI หรือว่าเข้าไปยังพื้นที่ EEC ได้เลยนะครับซึ่งก็มีกฎระเบียบอยู่แล้วแต่ว่ามันมีสิ่งที่ต้องพิจารณาคือว่าชิ้นส่วนที่จะผลิตเนี่ยมันสามารถใช้ได้ทั้งทางทหารแล้วก็พลเรือนหรือไม่นะครับเพราะว่าถ้าจะมาลงทุนในแง่ของการผลิตชิ้นส่วนทางทหารเนี่ยมันอาจจะต้องมีกฎระเบียบแล้วก็มีการควบคุมค่อนข้างมากนะครับแต่ว่าถ้าเป็นชิ้นส่วนที่ใช้ในอุปกรณ์หรือว่าเทคโนโลยีของพลเรือนอยู่แล้วเนี่ยมันก็จะง่ายกว่านะครับเพราะว่ากฎระเบียบทางทหารเนี่ยก็จะไม่ต้องควบคุมมากตรงนี้เนี่ยก็อาจจะมาคุยกับ DTI ว่าสำหรับบริษัทที่สนใจนะครับก็คืออาจจะมาคุยกับ DTI ว่าต้องการทำโครงการอะไรแล้วก็อาจจะมาศึกษาตลาดร่วมกันนะครับแล้วก็ดูความเป็นไปได้ของตลาดก่อนที่จะตัดสินใจร่วมกันว่าจะทำโครงการแบบไหนหรือยังไงนะครับผม next question is คำถามต่อไปนะครับก็คือเป็นอันนี้เป็นคำถามภาษาไทยนะครับเดี๋ยวผมถามเป็นภาษาไทยก่อนเดี๋ยวจะแปลเป็นภาษาอังกฤษนะครับคือว่าคำถามภาษาไทยคือว่ามีดีไทยเนี่ยมีแนวทางในการส่งเสริมหรือว่าพัฒนาเพิ่มขีดความสามารถให้กับบริษัทเอกชนไทยเนี่ยเพื่อเพิ่มขีดความสามารถในการแข่งขันทั้งในและนอกประเทศหรือไม่นะครับผม next question is there any pathway or any project to increase the productivity and increase the competitiveness of the Thai private sector to gain opportunity in local market and in defense market around the world, please.
Yes, sir. May I first? Okay. For your question, I would like to answer that. We surely you can come with us and together, and we can come together. We can to say that it's our authority and duty of us to promote and support them to do something about development, about your product, about your capability also. Sure, you can come to us and we'll together to discuss what would you like to do.
Is there any additional answer from Mr. Tharak?
One second, you mean about the another question about the Q&A section, right?
Oh no, this question about the competitiveness of the Thai private sector.
Oh, okay, that's right. About the competition in the Thai, in a Thai firm, right? They have two type of the purpose in this one. Actually, in the term of DTI, mostly we are do in house R&D already. But in another part, it's about okay, we are going to do the promote and support Thailand defense industry as well. So it means in DTI, we have some function like the defense company incubator. So it means about if you have some firm in Thailand that you have some capability already. This is important. You need to have some capability already, but you need to move your capability into the defense sector. This part DTI can support you, support both of information, regulation, or some kind of technology that mostly forbid for the civilian product as well. So it's mean about it depend on your market that you are going to observe. And this one about the some kind, how can we make a profit? Normally DTI is a public organization. The first purpose of us is not target about the make profit, but actually we have in our defense acts, we can separate another entity to make, produce, sell, and do the commercial section as well. So it depends on our objective of our partnership to do some kind of business in terms of the full scale business or not, or just start the know-how, the knowledge, and start to create a new network of the system as well.
Okay, this question, I will translate in Thai. ก็คือจากคำถามนี้นะครับคือคำตอบก็คือว่าDTI เนี่ยจริงๆแล้ว DTI ก็มีกลไกที่เป็นในลักษณะของ Defense Company Incubator ครับซึ่งก็จะเป็นการสนับสนุนในการสร้างโครงการหรือว่าอุตสาหกรรมป้องกันประเทศให้กับบริษัทในภาคเอกชนนะครับแล้วก็อย่างที่คุณรุ่งนรีตอบนั่นคือว่าถ้ามีแนวคิดหรือว่ามีแนวทางว่ามีปัญหาอะไรเนี่ยก็สามารถจะเข้ามาคุยกันเพื่อที่จะหาแนวทางในการร่วมมือกันนะครับผมWe approaching the end of the presentation, and in fact, we have some questions also, but I don't think we have enough time to answer all questions. But if you have more questions, maybe it's the best idea to send the email to the business development department at the showing at the slide right now. And maybe we need to move to the end of the seminar. So this is the conclusion for today's seminar, and I hope this would benefit you and give you some idea of how to work with the DTI to create the business opportunity for your company. Defense and Security 2022 by the GML Exhibition Thailand in collaboration with the ThaiArmedForce.com. We'd like to thank our speaker, Ms. Rung Nari and Mr. Tharak from DTI. And please don't forget, Defense and Security 2022 will be held in Thailand in 29 August to the 1st of the September next year. And we hope to see you there. And you can revisit our seminar here by visiting our Facebook page at the Defense and Security 2022. So in the meantime, before the exhibition happened, we will meet you online with the seminar each month, and please stay tuned for the next seminar and the topic. So today, thank you to our speaker, and thank you the participant, and thank you the attendee. So thank you and see you again.